It's something few of us talk about and even fewer understand. But there's a simple yet hard to believe fact, which means we must give it more attention. One in four pregnancies ends in a miscarriage. When it occurs, it's often associated with shame, blame, and guilt. And as you'll see, that's just as wrong as ignoring it. It starts out as a happy home video to mark Father's Day 2020.
This is actually the stillest they've ever been. Here comes
the sun. But very quickly, the laughter turns to tears.
Look out! Don't push it on him. Whoa! Look out!
For mum, professional filmmaker Tahina McManus, and her husband Tristan, this is no real surprise.
Oh, yep. Don't work with children.
But all is calmed with cuddles, and soon 4-year-old Echo and 18-month-old Oshin are happily distracted again. To the kids, mum's camera is a plaything. But to Tahina, it has proven vital in helping her heal, enabling her to give voice to the unspeakable pain of suffering 3 miscarriages.
It started as like a coping mechanism for me, like an online journal. And I was collecting all these videos, and I guess that everything just snowballed because I started to talk to my friends and to see a common thread. And I realised that perhaps this is a bigger conversation than just what I was feeling. And that's how the film was born.
What resulted was misunderstandings of miscarriage, a raw and sensitive insight into the world of pregnancy loss, a world where little is said because often no one knows what to say.
I kept thinking it was something I had done.
In it, we meet women who, while sharing similarly tragic experiences, considered themselves very much alone, isolated by grief, and even guilt.
At least you weren't far along. You know, everybody's situation is different, but my pain was my pain. And I felt for a little bit of the time that I was incredibly alone.
You explain it and they're like, oh, so it wasn't like real. It's like, oh, no.
It was.
It was.
Yeah. Like in my head, I was like,
you could say the guilt.
What's
guilt?
Wrong yeah. with me? I felt guilty. I felt like I just couldn't work it out.
Were you overwhelmed by the grief you encountered in telling this story?
Yes, I was very overwhelmed by the grief and knowing that I know what you're feeling and I can't help, I don't know how to help you right now. And so it was like we were all holding hands together and we were all saying, like, if we maybe all say this, then we can heal and move on.
Tahina McManus has grown up in front of the camera, first as a model, and then going on to act alongside Hugh Jackman in Wolverine Origins. Then in 2012, while living in Los Angeles, Tahina met and fell in love with cheeky Irish dancer Tristan McManus. Having babies was always part of the plan.
Well, certainly I was very naive to anything going wrong. I just assumed that you would want to have a family, and that's just what happens.
You just assume if you want to have kids, well then we know how to make kids.
And it happened quickly. Tahina sharing the news in a surprise Father's Day card.
It's a special surprise.
Huh? Howie? What? Howie?
Were you genuinely surprised in that moment?
Yeah, I mean, I didn't expect it. We were, and still are, so deeply in love with each other. It felt like the next progression of our relationship, where we were going to go. It was absolutely perfect.
But 8 weeks in, Tahina's pregnancy symptoms suddenly disappeared, and with them, her joy and dreams for her baby.
How devastating is it when it goes wrong?
I just kept thinking, No, like, this can't be happening. And I was 28 years old. So I always get really emotional when I talk about that first one. But I was just devastated. I was so devastated because I felt like everything that we had like hoped for in that moment was taken away really quickly. Mm. Yeah. Sorry, that first miscarriage gets me so much.
Are you all right?
Would
you
like... No, sorry.
Oh my gosh. That's okay.
I think just because the expectation was so high. Yeah.
Are you sore or anything, or...?
I'm a bit crampy, but anyway, I think that's normal.
Do you think anyone who has not been through it can comprehend how awful it is?
No. If your loved one dies, we go to a funeral and we honour that person and we can see that person and it's visceral and you get it, but when you're explaining an eight-week, you know, thumbnail embryo, it's hard. It's hard to explain that.
Well, because in that moment, that is your baby.
Exactly. Yeah. That's something that we made together.
Yeah.
But despite their grief, this couple was determined to be parents. And it didn't take long before Tahina fell pregnant a second time.
What do you think it is?
I don't know!
I have a little baby girl.
I knew it was a girl.
The pregnancy was perfect, and 9 months later, their baby daughter, Echo, was born.
We had imagined her for so long, and she just exceeded what we could have possibly hoped for.
Angry face. Show Daddy your angry face. Oh.
You are the funniest baby.
Tahina and Tristan would go on to have another gorgeous baby, their son, Oshin.
That's your brother. He's come out to say hello.
But not before another two devastating miscarriages. And each time they learned they were pregnant, their hopes were raised.
This happened this morning.
It's long.
Before their expectations were again heartlessly dashed. Tahina's third loss seemed particularly cruel, losing her baby while at work, directing a commercial.
I mean, how can you go back outside where everyone's waiting for you to call action and say, oh, sorry, everyone, I've just lost a baby. I just lost another dream.
I was the leader of a team of men and I just didn't want to make them feel uncomfortable.
With her third miscarriage, Tahina was spent, overwhelmed, exhausted and devastated.
In terms of multiple miscarriages, what sort of emotional toll does that take on you?
I actually just think the blame is heightened. At that point, you kind of go, okay, it's me. There's something wrong with me. There's certainly a sense of heightened shame.
What's the shame about?
It sounds ridiculous, but for me, it was my womanhood. Like, my body should be able to do this. Why isn't it doing this?
It doesn't get easier.
No.
I mean, I don't think it's really talked about very often, but the male grief over miscarriage. Did you feel that you had a voice in being able to express your grief?
I didn't want it to be something that was just so easy to get over by talking about it. We've been lucky enough, we've had two beautiful kids. Do you know what I mean? But you don't want to feel as though you've just kind of dismissed the other kids.
Yeah, then I just realised it's kind of could do with a bit of water at the moment. But
this pretty plant represents so much to Tahina and her family. She planted it in honour of her three miscarriages, her angel babies. A simple way for Echo and Oshin to know about their lost brothers and sisters.
So by having a symbolic mark of the loss, it's not holding on to the grief. It's not keeping it alive in that way.
No, you know, I guess that's why people have burials and funerals. It's that moment for you to say goodbye and for you to close that chapter and it lives on somewhere else.
You know, there is hope after miscarriage.
Aussie actress Claire Holt is now the mum of two beautiful children. But she too wants to add her voice and star power.
Every day, everywhere, babies are born.
To the conversation on miscarriage.
Hello, Stefan.
Starring in the US TV hit series Vampire Diaries, Claire was ecstatic to learn she was pregnant for the first time until her doctor offhandedly warned things may not go well.
And the doctor came in and did the measurements himself. The heartbeat was on the lower end and he said, listen, could go either way, don't put it on Facebook. It was such a shock for me, but it was also just devastating. Because he was quite glib about it.
At 10 and a half weeks into the pregnancy, Claire lost her baby.
That was the most crushing moment of my entire life. It was so heartbreaking for me, and I know it was so heartbreaking for my husband. And I said, I need to hear it. I need to hear that there's no sound. She put the microphone on and there was nothing. It was just silence.
It's the devastating outcome for one in four pregnancies. Heartbreaking news that IVF Australia fertility specialist Dr. Manny Mangat has had to deliver to thousands of grieving patients. She admits the medical language surrounding miscarriage is sometimes cold and harsh.
You know, so if the person you're sitting opposite can't say I'm sorry for your loss, then you feel embarrassed about those feelings of grief.
Absolutely. It doesn't matter whether it was an embryo or a fetus or a term baby. I think they deserve their time to grieve that loss.
As tiny and fragile as the very beginning of life might be, Dr. Mangat knows this is already a baby in the hearts of its parents, a precious connection doctors need to better accept.
We've always been taught from early on that we need to separate ourselves from our patients. But I've come to realise with all my training that you can't do that. There's nothing wrong in sharing their emotions, and there's nothing wrong with being a real person and not just their doctor.
It makes you cry.
Yeah. I love my patients. Don't record that.
Well, I'm sure they'd like to hear that.
Yeah. So... It is emotional, yeah.
And you see it firsthand?
Every week, yeah.
We're just all very, very proud of Tahina now with this documentary, all the hard work that's gone in. We're very, very proud. What's that?
These are noisy, happy days for Tahina and Tristan and their beloved family. Tahina's documentary airs on Stan this week. It was to give voice to the silent sufferers of miscarriage.
God, are you kidding me?
To make the world better understand their loss, never realising that most of all, Tahina might be helping herself.
I only really understood it in that last moment when I was sort of putting all the pieces together that, oh my goodness, this was my way of acknowledging those babies. I honestly didn't realise that that's kind of what I was doing and has really helped me in a way. It's been my own healing process making the film. Here comes the
sun. Relaxed and off guard, Tahina and Tristan give us clues on how they got through the toughest times. Love, a healthy dose of humour and a whole lot of laughter.
Great joy to talk to you both, so thank you.
Oh, we made it.
I don't even know what I said. I'm going to have to listen to this again.
Did you blank out?
No, I answered a question and everyone's looking at me weird. I was like, what did I just say? It's like, did we just have a fight about something? That was nice what I said. I don't know. I don't even know what I said now.
I don't even know what you said either. Don't worry. It doesn't matter.
Hello, I'm Tara Brown. Thanks for watching. To keep up with the latest from 60 Minutes Australia, make sure you subscribe to our channel. You can also download the 9Now app for full episodes and other exclusive 60 Minutes content.